maternity funerals, how may I assist you?
Sure, won't be one moment.
Yeah, Frank, Mrs. Jobs on the phone? Okay, no worries. Thanks, mate. Maternity funerals, how may I assist you?
Sure.
I understand, I'll just pop you through. Yeah, Sandra?
That loser, Mrs. Fitzcock.
Yep,
line 3.
Okay, hun. Maternity funerals, how may I assist you? Okay, sure. Won't be one moment. Yeah, hi, Brad. Mrs. Fletcher on line 3, please.
And if you pay up front, you get a 10% discount. That's right.
Of course we can organise finance.
Yes, we can do oak, maple, any kind of wood you like. Yeah? Yeah, sure.
Okay, well, we have a fixed term payment plan. It's whatever you can afford. Yeah?
Don't worry, you can pay it off in 20 years.
Yes. Well, can I put it back tomorrow?
It's a very good deal, really.
It's a great plan, it's guaranteed, and if you die young, you win. Hello?
Hello.
Hi Steve, it's Brad here.
Hi Brad.
Look, can we put off that meeting till after lunch? It's just I'm a bit swamped with those contacts you had for me.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, I don't know how you pick him. You know the guy who lives two houses up from me, Mr. Collins? Yeah, looks like he lost the fight with cancer. Yeah, they carted him away this morning.
How sad.
Oh, good call, Steve. Lucky for us, he didn't purchase the existing conditions cover, so his family still has to pay for the casket.
Yeah, well, you know what I always say? The devil
is always in the details. Look, Steve, I've got to go. I'll still see you after lunch.
Okay. I'll see you then. Oh, and Brad. Thanks for letting me know about Mr. Collins.
No worries. See you, boss. I'm just going to get a bite for lunch. I'll be back in less than an hour.
Oh, thanks, Brad. Did you get that promotion yet?
Not yet, but after lunch.
So, how was your weekend, mate?
Yeah.
Not too bad. Well, basically, like, the boss asked me on Saturday, dude, can you get those 5 reports done for me by Monday? Like, basically, I said, I can't get those 5 reports done by Monday, then. So,
you wouldn't believe it,
eh? Oh, I asked too much for it, so I'll get along, mate. Yeah, I'll get along. Thinking of changing jobs. How about yourself?
Yeah, doing stuff.
Here and there, nothing to do.
Are you alright, mate?
Are you alright? You alright? What, are you alright?
Call an ambulance! Anybody know first aid?
Brad, the CEO will see you at your desk.
Oh, okay.
Watch it, Brad!
see you. I thought you... Brad? Brad? What the hell's the problem?
I gotta get out of here. It's after me.
What do you mean? What?
It's going to get me. It could use anything. Cancer. Peanuts!
Brad, you're not making any sense. What is after you?
Don't you understand? Death! Death is after me! I gotta go. I gotta get away.
Look, Brad, I don't know what's gotten into you, but...
Steve! I saw him! It! Her! The black cape! The sickle! Only it had a woman's face! And she was there with Mr. Collins this morning, and she just killed a guy down the pub, and now she's after me! No one else can see her! I gotta leave. It's this job I know.
Look, you can't do this. I know who's behind this. Let me sort it out.
Sorry, Steve, I've already booked the flight.
Well, where are you going?
Perth. I got the first flight to Perth. I gotta get as far away from this place as possible.
Hey!
In my office. Now!
Think you are. You know that Brad is out of bounds. You can't go around scaring my employees like that. You scared him half to death.
Oh yes, Brad.
You know you're not allowed to touch him. I made a deal with your boss 5 years ago. And I know you've never lied, but a deal's a deal.
But you know how my boss is with contracts. Did you read the fine print? The devil is always in the details, right? Section 47A. Your staff are only protected in Queensland. And I won't be getting in touch with Brad until tomorrow. In Perth.